poke of the bait.
His own bread for his hamburger.
Now see, I think that's really good.
We got some little baits in there from Joe. Some big baits that I just caught in the net. His baits are the only ones that catch the fish.
Where's your boy?
About 500 feet of water where the color changes, and I'm gonna be putting on a nice redfin herring that we caught earlier. If I can grab wood, there we go. Right by that fin down here, like this. That guy's gonna take off like a rocket here in a second. Yep, it's like a rocket. Look at that guy, he's going straight down. Almost looks like something's already grabbed him, but I know nothing has. These are some big, strong baits. Cutie. Not super big. Don't bite me. Little tail. That's a nicer one. Charging the boat. Oh. A baby. Baby tail. Don't bite me. They really like that chewed up piece. I don't know why. There we go. Tie up. Some tiny little tails. Gonna need to try some bigger bait. It is the next day. You might be thinking we only have one bonita in the cooler, but as soon as the camera dies, there's always action, so I think it's just easier to show you the cooler. Let's see if I can. Yep. We have a few more fish in there than I showed on camera. Yeah, we have 2 11-inch mangroves. Big yellow jack. I think that guy's 19 to the fork. And then 2 yellowtails. One of them was 17 and a half, and one of them was 18 inches. Okay, well, we're gonna fillet this bonita first, I guess. Because why not? First, we are gonna go right behind the head. Like this. It's been a while since I filleted tuna, so if I mess up anything, please forgive me. But it's definitely not the right spot. Here we go. Gonna go all the way back into the head and come down like this right here. Just go right down the middle. You'll feel your knife bouncing on and off the spine. It's easier to do this on a black fin because they have a better lateral line. But this guy, just go right down like this, and his meat is very dark. That's not great, but I'm gonna still make them taste good. Originally, I was gonna do a trash can slam, catch, clean, and cook, which would have been grunt, blue runner, and bonita. But we caught some pretty nice fish, so I'm gonna turn it into a good fish, catch, clean, and cook, plus bonita. And I am confident I will make this bonita taste good. I'm just gonna go right along the backbone. You'll feel your knife stop about here. I'm just gonna go up and then up, try and break through it, go over, and go down. Now that you have this opening, you're just gonna pull the meat away from the bones. Here, just put it right here.
It's not shade.
It's okay for now. You're just gonna try and cut the meat away from the bones for the most part. This. Make sure this cut is deep enough, otherwise you will not be able to separate these. And I'm actually going to start going in an angle just to try and meet those two lines up, so that way I can pull this meat away and I feel I've already popped through this. Pop the knife out to the tail, and there we go. There's a piece of bonita. Not the best eating fish in the world, but we're gonna make it taste great. Okay, we are going to work on this other loin here. You're gonna take your knife and go back just like this, right? It's a bonita. I don't want to spill the guts everywhere. I'm just going to go like this. Because usually on a blackfin, if you want to get all the meat, you would go right here and then come down through the stomach. But I don't want to spill. Wait, no. He's gutted. Never mind. Oh, I already did it. I'll do this because I'm going to cut up the bonita into chunks anyway. So once I've done that, I'm going to flip him around. And I'm sorry, he probably cannot see this. I'm just gonna trace along the stomach, if that makes any sense. And then you're just gonna basically act like you're filleting the top of a fish. This is not the best angle. I'm just following the ribs down. This is not the easiest fish to fillet by far. I just need to get some meat off this. I'm not trying to get every single scrap off, but just getting some bloodline off, and this is what two loins of bonita should look like. I missed a little bit right here, and I'm gonna go in for this one right here. I'm just gonna come down. There we go. It has a huge bone in it. We'll just use him for bait. Okay, let's just flip over the other side, move this guy, try and move him out of the way a little bit, and I'm gonna do the other side. Oh, okay. Well, we're going. I'm just cleaning this lane snapper here. Yeah. I'll just let you watch. I'm not going to do too much talking. Or actually, I might talk a little bit. So, I'll tell you how the day went. After I turned off the camera, which I believe is at where I put the camera underwater, my dad hooks a rainbow runner, gets it over the rail, and he flops off. We go live line a little more. We're just we slow trolled a few live baits. Did not catch anything. We go into a spot about 17 feet. We caught two mangrove snappers. I think they're about 11 and a half, 12. Probably should keep this guy under here for some structure. It's a lot easier to fillet them like this. And the mangrove bite kind of shut off after we got two nice keepers. And we went out, before we went to catch mangroves, we went to go yellowtailing. We caught a whole bunch of yellowtails. They were all like 11 and just barely 12, so we let them all go. We go out to a wreck in roughly 100 feet of water, and we caught two 18-inch yellowtails and a 19-inch yellowjack. So that's how the day went, and I pulled out a little lane snapper, which I'm cleaning right now, out of that spot. Kind of messed this guy up a little, but it's okay. The canal pets will eat them. Or the canal fish, not pets. Just gonna skin this guy really quickly. This is just a Denko. I think it's a 7-inch cheap little flex knife. I think it's like $7 or something at Walmart. And this is gonna just be a burger in the long run. I'm just gonna chop this up. Trim out a little stomach lining and some lane snapper. Gonna set this on a relatively clean area and skin the other fillet. Got rid of that and cut. And we have two fillets of lane snapper. And now for the biggest fish of the day, this yellowjack. It's 19 inches to the fork. And I've only cleaned two of these. Yeah, I've only cleaned two of these before. And I maybe forgot how to do it, just a little bit. But I'm just going to treat it like a snapper, see if it has a high spine. And if I do, and if it does, I'll just kind of come around down here with my knife. So I should use a bigger knife, but I think this is fine because it's the only one I have super sharp. Yeah, this is manageable. Gonna go all the way up to the head. Oh, some nice white meat. Usually we do not get these here in South Florida. Well, no, here in Miami. It's usually what they're caught down in the Keys. We went and did one little trip in the Keys. I did not film it at all. I don't even think I filmed me cleaning them. But we caught about three of them, and they were all way smaller, probably 12 inches. Oh, okay, not bad. It's a big fish for this little knife, but it's handling it pretty well. Okay, and pulling apart. The meat is very soft and delicate, so when I put a little pressure on it, it pulled apart. But we will be slicing this huge fish into some sashimi later today or tomorrow. Probably not tomorrow, actually Tuesday. I'm not sure. But hopefully we get a little section of this video. Bonita catch, clean, and cook in yellowjack. Clean and cook. Because I did not catch that on camera. But we did catch him. Just going back along the spine. It's relatively hard to fillet a big fish like this just after filleting a tiny little lane snapper, but his spine is not too tall. It's actually comparable to a snapper's spine. Just gonna crack for all those pins, pin bones. Last one. The front. Oh, his pin bones go really far down. Reminds me of a tuna. Really have to hug that backbone, which is kind of hard. Gonna go around right here. We are back over to the other side. I'm just gonna go through here. I already popped. Did I pop through the pins? Nope, not yet. This meat is falling apart. Not really, but it is sure coming apart into flakes. It's making it hard to see. Just popping through these pin bones. It's probably not the most fun thing to watch. Oh, that's a hard pin bone. Probably get a serrated knife. How come I'm not popping through these pin bones already? Okay, I will just... There we go, got through there. I'm probably just dulled out my knife a ton. But that's okay. It's for a nice fish. That's for sure. I guess his spine is a little higher than I thought. But I already made the cut, so I will just kind of come through here on the inside. It's a big piece of fish. There you go. Got the last pin bone. And we're just gonna... Oops. Did not want to take that rib with me. Hello and welcome to today's cooking section of the Catch, Clean, and Cook. Right now I'm marinating some bonita. Actually not marinating, I'm soaking this bonita in salt, hopefully to get rid of the metallic taste. I don't know if it will work, but let me show you the seasonings that I'm going to use. Here we have maple, black bean sauce, chili garlic sauce, some sesame oil, and some soy sauce, and I just made this spicy mayonnaise using this hot sauce and some mayonnaise. So let me show you how we're going to use these. And here is our bonita. You might be wondering, why is there so little? The bonita was huge. So I ended up throwing away, or not throwing away, we're still going to use it for bait. I ended up not cooking a lot of it. The bonita meat somehow turned brown, and it had only been about 2 days. So, but here are the nicer chunks of bonito. This one's not very nice, but we'll still try it. Let's cook this stuff up. Okay, so I have a Ziploc bag right here. In this bag, I'm going to add all of this spicy mayo, which is about 3 tablespoons, I would say, but it's a tiny amount of bonito. I don't know. Okay. I've made this recipe before, but on a different type of bonita. It was an Atlantic bonita, not this little tiny bonita. I'm not sure exactly what they call them. They look a little bit different. Okay. Now that I have this empty, I'm going to add in a little bit of sesame oil. About 1/4 tea, if I had to guess. That was a little too much. but some good sesame flavor. One cap full. Actually, we'll do 3/4 cap full of soy sauce. So just your regular soy sauce. Actually, I don't know if that's regular, but the 15 ounces of light soy sauce, we're just gonna use the cap of it, the glass bottle. And then we're gonna use about 2 teaspoons of this Lee Kum Kee. I think I said that right. Yeah, Lee Kum Kee black bean sauce. That is it. I'm going to screw the lid back on this sauce, zip the bag up, and just mix it all up. I am so sorry. I just realized I forgot maple soy sauce. So we're going to use just about a cap full of that as well. Let's see if I can one-handed get the Ziploc open. And I did it. Okay, open it up and pour it in. Okay, let's mix it all up again. And now we are going to add in our bonita. And grab all of that, throw them in. Okay, let's get cooking. I have the fish right here in this bag, and I also have some avocado oil I mixed with one lemon. Let's get this in the pan. So first, I know the pan is hot. Make sure, oh god, that coated the pan instantly because it splattered everywhere. That's good. And we are going to take out our fish. Turn down the pan to medium heat. I just had it heating up there. And we're gonna put our fish into the pan. Here we have our pieces of fish a little bit spaced out, and we're gonna let these cook for a second, minute. Let's try some fish and some rice. Let's try some fish and some egg fry rice. That looks like breakfast sausage and scrambled eggs. I do not know why. But let's try the fish first, because that's probably the one that you guys want to see me try. This is the bonita that we caught early in the day on a little vertical jig. So let's try it. I cannot say it's great. It's okay. The aftertaste is really fishy, but whew. I'm not gonna say I recommend this. It's not great, but it's okay. I think it's good for bonita. Let's try the rice. This really isn't part of the video, the rice, but I'll try it anyways. And here we have some yellow jack that I just cut up. It's just raw, and we're gonna eat it sashimi style. Here we go. Just dipping it in some soy sauce and wasabi. Today I'm gonna try and teach you how to make some sushi. First, you wanna start off by having the right seaweed. Just any brand in this large sheet will do. You don't want something so small that your roll is tiny once you make it. So you wanna put this rough side, I don't know if you could tell, but this side is rough and this side is shiny for the most part. Smooth. You want this side up so your sushi rice sticks to it. First, I am going to spread the sushi rice all over the seaweed with this wooden spatula. I will see you in a second after I'm done with this. Okay, now we have all the rice laid out on the sushi paper. I will suggest don't use a spatula, it just makes the rice stick to it, and it just tore apart the rice and the seaweed. So first I have all of these ingredients over here, cucumber, carrots, and avocado. First, this rice is already seasoned with some vinegar and sugar, but I will season it with just a sprinkle of this. It has a little bit of kick to it, not too much. It's basically like dried egg, some sesame seeds. Actually, I'm not sure what it is. It might be bonita. Sesame seeds, chili, dried bonita, seaweed, sugar, soy sauce, beans, bonita extract. So yeah, that's what it's made out of. Now we are going to put on our cucumber. I am so sorry, the camera just died. Where did I leave off? Yes, so we're gonna put down our cucumber just in a row, preferably more towards this edge than that edge. I'm gonna end up rotating it around to roll it anyways, but it's okay. I think 3 fits across perfectly fine. I'm gonna go with my carrots now. Avocado, some big pieces of avocado, but should be good. And then one tiny piece. It's a good piece. There we go. You want to keep these ingredients relatively minimal because this fish is basically going to be the star of the show. This is that yellow jack we caught a few days ago. And I'm just going to put this all on top. I'm going to see how I'm going to show you how to roll it, because it's a two-hand activity. That's about the amount of fish I want. I'll just throw on some of the other scraps that I like, end pieces that when I cut the fish came off. Let me show you a time lapse. I'll just do a regular video of how to roll this. This little red container, I have some water, and I'm going to roll this up. Make sure all the rice is away from the mat. You do not want it getting stuck in your sushi mat. It'll be quite hard to get out. And it also sticks to your fingers. I'm gonna pick up this edge and just kind of fold it over, but hold all of your sushi filling, would it be called? I'm not sure. But you're just basically going to roll it, and then when it gets too far, you're just gonna pull this mat back. This mat is just used to make it into a circular shape. You do not want your mat getting stuck in the rice, so just pull it back when it gets down to where the rice is. Just make some nice tight rolls, and when you get to the end, you're gonna take your finger, dip it in that water. You might need a little bit of it, especially when your seaweed is fresh and not stale. I'm just gonna finish rolling it, put a little bit of pressure on it. Kind of squeeze it and then wrap it all the way back up again. Just gotta keep that circular shape. And then you will unroll it to get this roll. Let's cut into this, and I already can tell I did not use enough rice. But that's okay. I am sure it will taste good anyways. Onto the board it goes. Very sharp knife. This is what you're going to need to cut through the seaweed and rice all together and not make it fall apart. You really don't want to put too much pressure, just kind of doing a slight sawing motion back and forth. And once you get through, then you can apply more pressure. You really do not want to tear that seaweed. And that roll does not look appetizing. But there's also no avocado in there, and that's also the end. So I still believe there is hope inside there. Now once you get to the more dense part of the roll, you can apply a little bit more pressure. Okay, that's a better looking roll. It's not the fanciest, but it still looks great. You want to cut these in about maybe 1/2 inch thick to 3/4 inch thick rolls. So it actually feels kind of hollow on this side, which means my rice was not dispersed evenly and my avocado keeps wanting to pop out. So really want to saw. Do not put too much pressure. It will tear the seaweed and rip out your fillings. I'm so glad none of those fillings popped out, because that was awfully close to doing so. My cucumber popped out, but luckily it still fits back in. There we go. That one's not the best roll. I think we're gonna get one more out of there, and then we'll have some ends that I can eat. Because those are not going on the plate. So I have two extra rolls I can eat. Let me go make a few more of these. Here is a quite interesting thing that I carved out of a cucumber. So, first sight, it might just look like any ordinary cucumber, but I hope I'm opening this on the right side. It pops open, so I think I might try and hollow it out in the middle and make it like a wasabi serving device, hopefully. It might not be the prettiest, but it sure does taste good.